It don't get as retro as that right there. That is that's the original trout killing, trout catching bait right there. I mean.
Retro bassin', kicking some ass and wearing rayon jackets. Thinking about Bill Dance, watching these fish prance through my Ray-Ban glasses.
Hey guys, welcome to Retro Bassin'. So we are on the road this week. Happened to be in Metairie, Louisiana. Had a little bit of a work road trip. And you know, one of the favorite parts for me about getting on the road is not just the new fishing waters that I get to explore, but more importantly, the local privately owned fishing shops. So there it is, it's called Shag's. It happens to be in Metairie, Louisiana, just a little bit north of New Orleans. And we're gonna go inside and check this place out. A couple things I love about local shops like this. Number one is you get some awesome old school tackle. You know, long after Bass Pro Shops discontinues items, stops carrying them, Academy, same deal. Places like this still have a lot of old school stuff. In addition to that, there's a ton of cool local products that you can get at a place like this that you just can't get at the big box stores. So we're gonna head in here. We're gonna do a little bit of a tackle tour of this place. I'll see you on the inside. Okay, so here we are inside. Right out of the gates, as soon as you get in the front door, everything in this boat, $5 for $10. There's gonna be some really cool stuff right out of the gates. I love the bargain bins at places like this. Again, you talk about old school, discontinued baits. There should be some goodies. Let's check it out.
Okay, so here we are, the boat itself. Oh, okay, some old school H&H original minnows. Yeah, I'm gonna have to pick up a few of those. Some more H&H, a ton of H&H stuff here, by the way, guys. So local shop, hopefully we can hit that on the way back. Oh, look at that. That looks old timey, doesn't it? The Deadly Dudley. Yeah, that might be coming with us. Okay, another Deadly Dudley. I've heard of this. I've not fished with these before. But that looks like it would catch a bass. Obviously a redfish too. Hybrids. Okay, so this isn't necessarily super old school, but this is definitely a bait that I think might be discontinued. I've picked these up before. I used to fish these for stripers back in the day.
All right, check it out. So I have historically not fished with a ton of H&H stuff, but definitely an old-timey bait company that's based just down the street in Baton Rouge. Check out this wall of H&H soft plastics. Holy smokes.
All right, so these are some redfish killers. Anybody who fished the redfish knows that H&H minnow tails are money. But I think you could catch a bass on some of these guys too.
So I picked up recently a bunch of old school beetle spins, and some of the tails are not in the best shape. So honestly, check this out. Like replacement beetle spin tails. And these are the big ones too. That'll work. So definitely gonna grab a few of those. It's funny, but back in the day, like the Virgil Ward Bass Buster days, they made some actually really big beetle spins, and getting the tails for them honestly has been kind of tough for me. So the 3-inch H&H sparkle beetle, that's gonna work.
Check out those guys. Ooh, look at that color. What is that? Blue Moon Chartreuse Tail. Dude. Yeah, that'll work. I like that color. Cock of the Walk. And this thing, that... I love that green color. That's a very salt watery color, but that would work on a bass. Ooh. these are hard to find. So Bass Assassin Saltwater Curly Tails. Actually, I love these things. I never ever see them anymore. Used to catch a ton of bluefish and stripers on these guys. Sometimes I like that curly tail better than a paddle tail. And that's an acid rain. That's a sweet color. Oh, and this is another one of my favorite Bass Assassins. So these are the sea shads. I think it's like a 3-inch or maybe it's a 4-inch. Check out that color. Oh man, that's old timey. What's the name of that? Northern Minnow. Yep. That would work.
If you've seen any of the recent mail calls, you know that I've been on a little bit of a mirror lure kick. They still do make those lures today, and these guys have a big old selection. Check this out.
Some of these guys are the newer versions of the mirror lures. Honestly, they have some pretty sick new color patterns. And these, dude, definitely look old-timey. That is like a vintage mirror lure. The packet is even worn out. Yep. That's a tough color to find, so look at that. Redhead, but it's got the chartreuse back and belly. And then there's another one. That's the tiny trout version. You can tell because it's got the speckles on it. That fish is a little bit different than the original mirror lure. The I guess like the 51M is the original. That one's a little bit different. Oh, I got one of those. Check out that dude. Oh man, that's an awesome old school color. Yeah, these are definitely not new mirror lures, for sure. These have been on the rack a little while.
So this place is like the mother load of H&H baits. Check this out.
A ton more sort of beetle spin replacements there. Look at those guys. Cajun tails. Oh man, I'm definitely walking out with some of these. See what I'm talking about though? So look how big that is. That is a big old beetle spin. I've got some of the original Bass Buster ones they used to make of this, but the replacement tails on the Johnsons, they don't have because they just don't make beetle spins this big anymore. But those are monsters. I like this size though because you can actually cast that on a bait caster really well.
All right, so also to check out this, I don't even know. So I guess this is the H&H version of the beetle spin. It's called the Cajun spin. I don't know about y'all, but I love the old school pack when you would just go like take one off and then like leave the rest of them on.
And the key is when you get to a tackle shop, you can kind of tell what are the most popular ones. Like for example, this guy.
There's just one left. So that means that's a good color. I don't even know what that is. And then if you see this one, maybe not quite as popular just because, well, there's only been a couple of them taken off.
Ooh, look at that. Smelly jelly. This stuff I used to fish with a pretty good bit back in the Northeast. Trouble is, on a hot summer day, this whole thing melts and it turns into like, instead of smelly jelly, it's more like smelly soda.
Oh, cool. I think I see some local spinnerbaits over here. All right, guys, check this out. It's a humdinger. Bass catchinest lure around.
Look at this giant wall of nothing but, honestly, old school. I think that is totally a living rubber skirt, by the way. Oh, man. Almost looks like a wall of oaky bugs or something, doesn't it? But that is what I'm talking about here. You just do not get. I've never even heard of this brand before. Humdinger. Let's see, what's it say? More vibration. Those look awesome. All right, we're gonna grab a few of these humdingers. That looks old timey.
So that's awesome. That is something you definitely don't see at Bass Pro. Sorry, guys. Just a bunch of old school, super local spinnerbaits. Made of living rubber, too, by the way. Like, what? All right, guys. So this is Korey. He has been giving me a little bit of the tour of the place. So what do we have up there, man?
That's an old Minn Kota trolling motor from God knows when. I don't even know when. It's heavy. Let me tell you what. We had to put that thing up there. I think it runs off an old battery, and you can see where it hooked to the transom right there.
Look at that. So as you guys know with this show, it's mostly old, discontinued baits, but I do like to give shout-outs to local stuff. I just don't think guys like this get enough press.
They don't get enough credit.
They don't get enough credit. You don't see them at the big box stores, and there's some really sick stuff. So even though it's not retro, it's still worth checking out.
Right out of Plateau, Louisiana.
Oh, wow. Oh, those are money looking.
Yeah, no, that's
like, how do you rig those guys up?
On a jig head, like your old Kako Minnows.
Okay.
This is another take on the Kako Minnow.
Yeah. Oh, and it's a shrimp.
And that's his TKO shrimp.
Yeah. Nice, man. Where do you fish with these guys?
Everywhere. I fish Lake Pontchartrain, Grand Isle. Grand Isle's my honey hole, man. That's my favorite place to fish with them.
Nice. Okay, very cool. So are these good for reds and?
Reds, trout, bass.
Okay.
You name it. A fish. If it eats a fish, it'll eat it.
Oh, dude, awesome. By the way, I love that color.
That's Limbo Slice.
Look at that.
My favorite redfish color right there.
I love a green. No one fishes with a green anymore.
Green and blue.
Dude, green's a great old school color.
Lemonhead, shrimp creole, two top sellers. You can see, we can tell we keep it stocked pretty hot and heavy in here.
And that's why it's like, by the way, guys, as soon as you walk in the door, boom, right there.
Right.
So it is.
MatrixShad.com.
All right, guys, I'll drop a link down below, matrixshad.com. That's sweet. All right, what other stuff? This is definitely some local stuff, man. So show me what else you got.
Overcast Lures, out of Alexandria, Louisiana. A little higher up in the state, but he...
Good boudin up there, by the way.
Oh, the best boudin.
Okay. And, so tell me about these guys.
Out of Alexandria, Louisiana, he makes really, really good baits. Really, really great action to them. I mean, they got a little bit of a smell to them.
Oh, yeah?
And the fish just absolutely go crazy for them.
Ooh, look at that.
Fish is absolutely going nuts for him.
Dude, those look nice.
My top color right here is my salt and pepper. That is the best color right there for him.
So what kind of jig head do you fish on that?
It's a little quarter ounce, 3/8 ounce jig head.
Would that work in freshwater too, you think?
Would it work? That's my favorite bass lure right there.
All right, dude, that's awesome. Very cool. So, all right, let's see if these guys have a website too.
Yep. I'm pretty sure it's overcastlures.com.
We'll check that out.
Yep. Overcastlureco.com.
All right, guys, I'll drop a link to that one down below too.
Ghost Minnows, Captain Lane's Ghost Minnow, and Mullet. Out of Lafitte, Louisiana.
Okay, dude, nice.
You were talking about the old Deadly Dudleys over there.
Yeah.
That's the new version of Deadly Dudley right there. Straight tail Deadly Dudley, trout killing machine right there.
Dude, that's a good looking little bait too, man.
Straight tail, slow fall, built for the wintertime fishing.
You see, and it's crazy, this stuff doesn't even get out. So I'm from Austin, Texas, and I've never seen any of this stuff at all. These guys, Mad Mullet, we'll check out if they've got a... I didn't think they got a website, huh? Dude, they may not.
They may not.
Oh, no, it does. www.ghostminnows.com. Okay, guys, I'll drop links to all these down below. And then more, dude.
High Water Fishing Lures out of Louisville, Louisiana. Captain George Spivey, he makes... Very similar to Matrix Shad, very similar to all.
Dude, this is a good looking body. Holy smokes.
This is my favorite color. This is one of my favorite colors right here. That's vermilion brown when they get on the Kakajo minnow bite down here.
Yeah. So that's a real thing, a Kakajo. I wonder how
it's literally called. It's the real name for it's a Gulf killifish.
Yeah, okay.
We call them Kakajo minnows down here, and talk about a fish catching.
That bait's got some curves to it, though. That's not like just a straight up bait, man.
No, it's a fine little bait right there. That's the glass minnow color. I mean, talk about great tail action. Got a little smell to it. Like,
not bad though.
Just absolute fish catching machine.
Dude, that's awesome, man. So we've discovered like four new companies in the past like 5 minutes.
Yep.
So another website. Let's see. What is this one? www.highwaterfishinglures.com.
Yep.
Nice, man. And then H&H too, right? So, or is this another? What's this?
This is a Texas bait. This is a Texas, right out of Texas.
Whereabouts? Probably East Texas.
I'm pretty sure around Eastern Texas. I'm not exactly sure off the top of my head. That's the Trout Support. That is my favorite sight fish and redfish bait ever.
Dude,
Talk about just a big redfish killing machine.
Yeah.
You rig it up weedless and just those areas you can't get a bait through the grass. And you can't. That bait will come through Vietnam, we say. That's my big selling point.
So the tail on that thing looks funky though.
It's not a very impressive looking bait. I tell people all that. Looks can be deceiving, and this is a great.
You can already see the vibration on that thing.
Yes.
So look at that, guys. Oh. Okay.
Cast a mile too. I throw it on my Metanium with 50-pound braid. I dump my spool.
Now, do you put this on a jig head or a belly weight?
Belly weighted hook.
Okay.
Yeah. Not even weight. I wig it weightless.
Dude, there you go. Oh, really? Weightless?
Yep.
Does it have any salt in it? Like, does this sink down a little bit?
No. It stays about yay below the surface.
Okay, dude. That's awesome, man.
It is the deal.
The Trout Support.
Right out of Texas. Great shallow water trout fishing bait. They use them for speckled trout in Texas. That's what they catch all them 30-inch speckled trout on.
Troutsupport.com. I'll give you that one back. There you go, dude.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so we got one more. What are these called?
These are the Down South Lures. These are my surf fishing killing machines. This is my favorite color right here. Color X. 4.5-pound trout on it this year.
Dude, look at that dog.
That's
a long tail.
Yes.
That's a really unique looking.
You would think they would
tail.
Short strike it, but they blow through their gills when they hit it. It is the baddest big trout bait out there.
That is awesome. So Down South Lures, so where are these guys from?
Texas. Galveston, I want to say.
Okay. So hold on, guys. So another website to check out is www.downsouthlures.com. Those look funky.
Yep.
So like with all this saltwater stuff, so I grew up, I was a big saltwater guy before I got into bass fishing. So how many of these things cross over?
Every one of them cross over. We call redfish here spot tail bass. There ain't nothing a redfish will eat that a bass won't. There ain't nothing a bass won't that a redfish won't.
But there's not a time, I mean, I'm sure guys are, but you don't really hear about this stuff from bass fishing guys.
No, you don't.
But like, that's a swim bait, dude, all day long.
Yeah.
And that's, I mean, I could smoke some bass on Lake Austin with that thing, no doubt. Awesome.
All these, every one of them. I tell everyone, there's no wrong answer here.
Yep, you can get, but that's, those are some money baits.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
And then H&H, yeah, I might stop there on the way back, actually.
H&H is great, man. They're out.
So they're out of Baton Rouge, right?
Yes, sir.
So one of the bigger local companies, are these like one of the, is this like the original
the
Louisiana?
The original Louisiana bait, it is quintessential. It's Louisiana to the core.
Okay. Nice, man. And they've got like, I don't know if they have a shop or what, but the factories,
giant factory. It's like I say, it's Louisiana. Like when you think Louisiana, you think H&H.
And then the Beetle Spins, dude, I was looking at these guys.
It don't get as retro as that right there. That's the original trout killing, trout catching bait right there. I mean,
so it was like literally been about what we've walked like 5 feet and I saw five new companies that I've never heard of. So that's awesome. I'll drop links to all those guys down below. Man, I need to come fishing here next time. I feel like, so I'm here for work and I didn't get, we didn't fish at all.
We blow everyone else out the
water. No boat.
You don't need a boat around here.
Really?
No.
Whereabouts?
I go Grand Isle, Leeville, Venice, Burris. No boat needed. You go pull up any dead end canal, you catch all your trout and redfish.
All right, so I'll be back here in like December, dude. I'm gonna come back, we'll go. Awesome. By the way, you guys have a website for the store?
We have a Facebook page.
Really, is it Shags or Chags, by the way?
Shags.
So it's Shags. Okay, CH threw me off. A buddy who's from here, he goes, oh no, it's Shags. I'm like, all right.
Yep.
So, awesome, man. If you guys come in to Shags, definitely come talk to Korey. He's a ton of knowledge on local stuff. And next time we get here, we 1,000% are going to do some fishing. Okay, so that was like honestly one of the coolest old school ultra local tackle shops that I've ever been in. I am super excited to get back here to Louisiana. So I did a little bank fishing this week. I didn't have a ton of luck while I was out here. I didn't have a ton of time, to be honest with you, but I passed this place, Shags, and I'm like, I gotta go check this out. I spent like 2 hours in there today. So anyways, awesome. Korey, thank you for the tour. I'm definitely gonna hit Shags again. I've got to go back and check out. till next time, guys. Keep it local, and definitely fish it old school.
Fishing it old school. This old stuff rules. Welcome to Retro Bassin.